Hi, in this video we're going to talk about another descriptor of a curve. And so this descriptor is called torsion, not torque, torsion, similar word but not the same exact thing. Similar concept but not the same thing. So you should pause the video and write these things down, or write them down while I'm talking about them. But you'll want to take some notes so you can go back and think about this later and be able to answer questions about something like this on a test. Okay, so first here we have the definition of torsion. Torsion, this is a Greek letter tau, lowercase tau, used for torsion. Torsion is defined this way. Okay, so we've got several things going on there. We've got our unit binormal vector. But what we have here is the rate of change of that unit binormal vector with respect to arc length. We've got our unit normal vector, n. We have a dot product between those two things here. So the derivative of a vector function with respect to s would be a vector dot another vector. That gives you a scalar, which could be positive, negative, or zero. And then the minus sign out front here will change the sign on whatever the sign is from that dot product. This minus sign out here will change the sign on that. So when we look at some examples, we'll talk about the positive or negative idea here. So a couple of important concepts related to the properties of torsion. As with curvature and as with the T, N, and B vectors, this is defined in terms of S. Remember that B and N are both defined in terms of S. And then here we have a rate of change with respect to S. So this is defined in terms of S, which means that torsion is a descriptor of the geometry of the curve, independent of whether an object is moving fast or slow, or speeding up or slowing down as it moves along that curve. So any of these things that we've talked about that are defined in terms of that arc length parameter, the important idea there is that that's really describing the geometry of the curve. Torsion is a scalar, right? We can talk about that from the dot product of two vectors. It's a scalar, and it can be positive, negative, or zero, depending on the sign of this dot product, and then that will change the sign here. And then the last thing here, property, describing this, it's a little bit difficult to see from just looking at the formula here, so we're going to look at an example here, but thinking about what torsion describes, that it describes how twisty motion along a curve is. That's a very, you know, non-mathematical way of describing what's going on here, but we're going to look at some examples and kind of think about torsion with those examples. So I have here my football that I used in another video when we talked about the T, N, and B vectors. And we talked about that if we throw the football in, let's say, a parabola kind of shape, if we throw the football in a parabola kind of shape, we can think about where our T, N, and B vectors are. And so if that football goes in that parabola shape, the T vector is going to be tangent to that motion. So out front here, my T vector is tangerine. So I use orange vector for that. All right, so there's my T vector tangent to my motion. My n vector is on the concave side of that curve. That's my natural vector. And so that will be perpendicular to my t vector and on the concave side of that curve. So for this particular motion of this football, it will look something like that. So I've got a 90 degree angle here. So my t and n vectors there. And then if we think about the b vector, I can use my right hand rule to think about the t cross n. Gives me my B vector, so I put my right hand with my fingers in the direction of the T vector, so I can pull my fingers toward the second vector in my cross product, T cross N is B, and so the B vector is going to be in the direction of my thumb right toward you. So these would all be forming a right angle to each other, and that B vector is coming straight toward the screen here. All right, so if I throw this football just in a parabola shape, what I want you to focus on for a second here is that B vector, which is coming straight toward you. that B vector, and I want you to think about DBDS. So I'm going to make that football move again, and what I want you to think about is DBDS. So that B vector is pointing straight toward you here. As we go through the parabola, the B vector is still pointing straight toward you. Remember that it's a unit vector, so it's not changing length. So if it's changing, it would have to be changing in direction. My T vector is changing, and my N vector are changing. They're both changing direction. But you should notice that that B vector, it's not changing at all. That B vector is not changing at all. It's one unit long, and it keeps pointing the same direction. So although we've moved along this curve, that B vector is pointing straight toward the screen here, and so that is not changing at all, which means DBDS would be zero. This describes the rate of change of B with respect to arc length as you move along the curve. So in this particular kind of motion, DBDS is zero, the zero vector. But when I dot product that zero vector with N, I'll get zero, the scalar, and then zero. So what I'm showing right here is zero torsion. There's no twist really to my motion, but when you throw a football, that's not really how you usually throw a football. It doesn't usually go in a perfect parabola. It's supposed to have spin on it. And so when you think about a football moving with spin on it, so in that parabola shape, but rotating as it goes around that parabola shape, I'm going to exaggerate the rotation a little bit so we can really see what's going on here. So a wobbly spiral, throwing a football in kind of a wobbly spiral. So if we think about what's happening, it would be sort of like a helix, but moving around that shape of that parabola, right? And the tighter the spiral, the smaller the radius on that helix would be. But we're going to kind of exaggerate this a little bit. So as we move around here, the curve would be curving under. And so the N vector is always on that concave side of the curve. T vector, the N vector is on the concave side of the curve. So when it's on the bottom of that spiral, the N vector would be pointing up. Your B vector's here. As it moves around the top of that spiral, that N vector has rotated around. Your B vector then is forced to rotate around as well. And so for what's happening here, my T vector is not doing anything too much different than it did before. It's essentially following that parabola, maybe with a little wobble. But my N and B vectors are changing a lot. And so your DBDS in this example would not be zero. And this would describe a curve that has a lot of torsion on it, this lateral roll or twistiness to the motion of this curve. So another way to describe this here, besides twisty, I think our textbook uses the word twisty, but you could also describe that in terms of a lateral roll as you move along a curve, right? So this football example is a great one to sort of remember on a test, to think about what curvature and torsion are describing. Curvature is describing the bend of that curve, so essentially that kind of parabola shape, or even if we have the spiral, that's not changing too much. Remember that curvature describes how the T vector changes. So that wasn't too much difference whether I had roll or spin along that motion or not. But what was really dramatically different in those two different motions of the football is that twist, what the N and B vectors are doing. And so when I've got that spin on the football and that rotation around there, that's when I have a lot of torsion going on in my curve here. The other thing to think about would be whether that torsion in that particular example that I'm describing happens to be positive or negative. It's not zero when we've got that spin, but thinking about that torsion as being positive or negative. And so you can think about that by thinking a little bit about how this B vector is changing, and then remembering that a dot product represents an angle between two vectors, or describes an angle between two vectors. So if I have my football, this would be when it's on the top of one of those spirals with that N vector pointing inward. And then as it rotates around that N vector on the concave side, so when we're kind of on the back side of that spiral, your N vector would be pointing straight toward you. The B vector has rotated up. And so what we want to think about is how the B vector changed so that I can think about this DBDS. Right. So as I make that rotation, that B vector is rotating away from that N vector, right? That B vector is rotating away from the N vector. They still form a 90 degree angle, but what you want to think about is the change here. The B vector is rotating away from that N vector, so DBDS would be pointing that way, away from the N vector, which would mean that the angle between DBDS and N is an obtuse angle. So in this example, my DBDS dot N would be negative, but then the minus sign out here would change that torsion to positive. So this example that I've described here, I've got a positive torsion as that T vector, or the B vector rotates away from the N vector. You've got a positive torsion on this. All right, so one more video that we're gonna look at. The other thing that you might think about here with these properties is noticing that since the torsion is defined in terms of S, you really would rather not have to go through S to calculate torsion. You would really like to have an alternate formula for calculating torsion. So we're gonna do that in another video, talk about an alternate formula used to calculate torsion, and do an example of actually calculating that for a curve.